G'day and welcome back to Buildsome. So we've completed our grid survey on our block of land, got our RL points all drawn or written in. Now we actually can go about plotting where our contours are going to be. So firstly we need to know what contour intervals we need. So I'm going to use half a metre contour intervals. So obviously starting at zero, half a metre, 1 metre, so on. So we'll start with our half a metre contour line. So I'm going to have a look for the 2 points where that's going to go through. And obviously it's going to go between 100 and 800. So this is where I want to start my plotting my contour lines. So first thing I need to know is the difference between these 2 points. And just to keep it in the positives, we'll take this point here. So second RL minus the first RL will give us 700. So there's a 700 mil difference in height between those 2 points. Next thing I need to know is the grid line length. So how far apart are these lines on my scaled plan? Don't worry about what you did when you marked the site out. On your scaled plan, how far apart are they? And on this one, they're 10 mil apart. So what we do is we take that 10 mil and we divide it by our difference, or our 0.7 in this case. That gives us 14.285. So what that tells us is how far apart a metre would be in this particular grid square, or this particular square. Okay, it doesn't have much relevance to us at this point, but that's what we need, that 14.285. So now what we want to know is the difference between our first RL, this 100 here, and the RL that we actually need, or the contour interval we need, which is the half a metre. In this case, that's 400 mil, or 0.4. And we times that by the 14.285 that we got here, and that gives us 5.714. So that 5.714 is the number of millimetres that it is from this first RL to where our half a metre contour line will cross this line. So we can measure 5.714 and put a mark on our line there. So now it's just a matter of pretty much repeating the process. We'll go and have a look at the next two. So half a metre, it's not going to cross that line. It's going to cross between these 2 points. So 0.53 minus 100 gives us a difference of 0.430. We know that our contour line is 10 mil. So we can divide the 10 mil by the 0.430. And that gives us a difference, or a figure of 23.256. And then the difference between our first RL and our contour RL is 400 mil, and 400 mil times 23.256 gives us 9.302 millimetres from here down to where our contour line is going to cross. And we can put a mark there as well for that. I have got a little Excel type calculator. I'll put the link over the video here somewhere. And if you want to use that rather than work this out in a calculator, you're welcome to use that. So the next step, obviously 500 is going to come between these two somewhere. So again, second RL minus our first RL gives us a difference of 0.440. We know, again, this is 10 mil divided by 0.440 gives us 22.727, and 0.09 minus 0.5, which is our contour line RL, gives us 0.41. 0.41 times our 22.727 gives us 9.318. And we can put a mark there. So hopefully you're starting to see the pattern. So now find our next two lines. It's going to be these two. Find the difference. Work out that figure there. and work out how many mil it is, which in this case 3.412. Mark that. Put a little mark in our drawing. And we've got one last one to do. It's going to cross out of the site here. So do the same procedure as far as calculations go with that. And we get 8.05. So now we've plotted all the points for our first RL, our first contour line. We can draw just straight lines between those. So that's going to give us a rough idea of where our contour line will run. Obviously, contour lines aren't straight, so we can use a bit of poetic license, or artistic license, I should say, and we can just curve that line around to give us a more realistic shape of the ground. So that's our first line. Then we have to plot our second contour line, which is at a meter. So it's going to go between these two. It'll come down between this one, between here. It'll come between this one. It'll come somewhere between here, somewhere here. And yeah, so you get the idea. I'm not going to go through all the calculations again, but that's roughly what it looks like. And similarly for our third contour at 1.5 meters, and our fourth contour at 2 meters, and our last contour at 2.5 meters. So we're starting to see a little bit of a high point in this corner of the site. So there you go, that's how we can use our grid survey to develop the contour lines on our site plan.